What's up, guys? This is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you hit that like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, we're going over the last of the raster rendering types. I finally got some time to go ahead and put this video together, so let's get to it. All right, so I have this piece of raster data here, and let's go ahead and go into the settings. We already know pretty much where we're going. Go to the settings. Last render type is right here on contours. We'll select that. And in our contour properties, symbology or render type, we have several different options here. The first option is, what input band do you want to work with? And by default, the band 1 is selected. Now, with the raster rendering, you may have noticed that all of these settings are dealing with pixels and with the modification of pixels. And this one's no different. Usually, when you deal with contours, you're dealing with elevations, right? But with the raster rendering, we're not dealing with elevations. We're dealing with pixels and pixel values. So with this method, you'll be able to contour your pixel values. So let's go ahead and get into it. The next thing is contour interval. What is the contour interval? At what value do we want, or what value interval do we want to contour by? So what does that mean? First of all, let's see what the values are that we're working with here in band 1. If we go to the information tab and we scroll down, we'll see that there's no information in the band 1. Let's scroll down to the very bottom. No information. So this is how raster data is sometimes. But if you watch my older videos, you'll know how to find what values that you're working with in a specific band. Now, there are several ways, but we're going to use this method. We're going to go to symbology and literally just flip back over to multi-band color. And now it's going to let us know what our bands are, what our original bands are. So from the 98 to the 255 are our bands that we're working with. So let's jump back over here to contours. And I believe, let me pull my calculator up, wrong thing, calculator. How many values is that 255 minus that 98? Is about 157 pixel values that we can manipulate here, or contour. So if we have 157 values that we can manipulate or go that we can iterate through 157 values, that means that our interval is going to have to be smaller or fit within the range that is acceptable. Now, what in the world do I mean by that? Well, let's just try to contour. Let's try to contour. Let's do 200. Contour 200, right? Or actually, the top side was the 255. So we put in here 256, and we contour by this, right? We hit apply. You'll notice that there's nothing there. Why is that? Because this interval, the starting point is bigger than any of the values in the lineup, okay? But let's say if we did, let's do 250. 250, and we'll hit apply. Now you'll see this is within that range of that 255. So the interval, the first interval starts at the 250. So if we were, where was it? Let's say multiband color. If we start at the 250, we have very little room to go up. We only have 5 values left, right? But if we jump back over here to contours, let's say that we started our intervals at maybe 10. Now, how many intervals can fit within that 157 if we have 10? All we need to do is say 157 divided by 10. So what is that? And I'll do it so you can actually see it. We'll do that 157 divided by 10 is 15 intervals, right? 15 intervals left in there. So let's go ahead and do that and see how much more we're able to see with more intervals being run. So let's go ahead and type in, what did I say, 10? Apply. Now we can see a little bit more definition. All right, so each 10 here, from the 98 to the 255, so where would the first 10 be? If our lowest value is 98, we're gonna add 10, and we're now at what? We add 10, we're at 108 is our first contour value. Then we add 10 more, 118 is our next contour value. Then we add 10 more, 10 more, 10 more, all the way until we run out and we reach that 255 top. And 255 may not even be in there, because if we're adding just 10s, it's not going to capture that 5. But anyway, you can also manipulate the contour symbol. All right, so you can actually, you don't have to have a specific color. You can have whatever figures or whatever images that you want to put on these lines as well. So that is the contour interval. Now, if the contour interval is confusing to you, please drop it in the comment section and I will definitely get to it and further explain it. The index contour interval. What in the world does that mean? So this is basically going to be the marker for your contour interval. So to index, let's say we were going by tens and we went through a certain amount of intervals. Let's say we know that we have 15 intervals to go through. What if we want to know where every three intervals happens? Okay, we'll put in here contour interval of 3, and this will make that third interval become a marker. So if we hit apply, and I did not do that right, I need to change the symbol so we can see a difference here. So we'll configure symbol, make this just a little bit thicker so we can tell the difference from it and the rest of the image, and we'll hit OK. And so we know we have 15 intervals to go, so there should be 5 levels of indexed contour intervals. So now we'll hit apply, and as you can see, there's a little bold action that happened out here. Let me zoom in here. So every three iterations, or did I say that right? Every 3 iterations. So if it adds 10, adds 10, adds 10, that third add gets the marker. If it adds 10, adds 10, adds 10 again, that sixth add gets the marker. And that's why you see some of these are bold and some of these are not. Now you can actually figure out which ones will be getting those bold markers just by simply saying, okay, we know the bottom is 98. We added 10, we're at the 108. We added 10, we're at the 118. We added 10. And now on that third one, it's going to be that marker. One thing that I would want to see further done on this application is for labels to be put in. If these could be labeled, that would be amazing. But there are other methods. You can actually transition this into a vector layer and layer it and label it that way. But I would like to see labels in this specific part of the application. The last thing we have here is input downscaling. So what in the world does that mean? All right, well, first I'll just give you a visual representation of what it means. As we decrease, decrease this number, the details become clearer. As we increase the number, the details become more obscure. So let's go ahead and take this down to 1. We'll apply this. And now we can kind of see kind of the details in there. These little lines are very, very discreet, or they stand out by themselves. Now, if we increase this number, let's say we give it, let's do 10 right here, and we'll hit apply. You'll notice that detail is being lost, right? So why in the world would you want to increase or decrease the detail? Well, I guess that all depends on how specific, or how that depends on how you want to view the pixels. Do you want a more smooth contour that isn't as detailed as this, the number 1? This one isn't smooth at all. There's a lot of jagged edges. There's just too much to look at. And there's not a not well-rounded edges here, okay? But as you decrease the detail, you start to get that curvature. Let's give it 20 and see what 20 does in here. All right, this doesn't even look like any kind of shape, but what it is capturing is all of the possible outlier pixels out here. And that's what I mean by it looks more smooth, I guess smooth would be the best word there. It looks more smooth. It's capturing those outlier pixels. And as you decrease this number, it doesn't capture those outlier pixels. It sticks to a specific value, or closer to a specific value. Anyway, I explained these things in the other video, so not gonna go over that. That's just a short on contours. If you have any questions or any comments about anything I just went over, if it was confusing or anything, please let me know in the comment section. If you got it, you can just put in the comment section, I got it. But anyway, that is it with the contouring of pixels, and that is the last render type that we're going over. I have some more requests that I'm going to be working on, so I will get those out as soon as possible. Sometimes finding time to actually do the video is the hardest thing. But anyway, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.